Yes, good morning, students. Under chapter 9, there is a poem called The River, which we have studied today in our online class. This is a beautiful chapter or the poem that we have. The poet Valerie Bloom, who says that river is compared to a wanderer or nomad or tramp, one who always moves around, never stays in one place, and she does not choose one place, he says, and to set up a tent to stay for a while. Never. The river always is on the move. It goes on flowing. So it is compared to a wanderer or nomad or a tramp. Second stanza, the river is compared to a winder, which is always in turning and twisting, never straight. Its way is never straight. You never find the river bank in a straight line. It is all twisting and curving. She twists and she turns and just cannot be still. So never still and always in the twisted and curving mode she flows down. The third stanza, the river is compared to a hoarder. Hoarder, one who hides things, collects things, accumulates things, or gathers things and buries them. So just like with the flowing river water, the river collects everything that is on the way, on its way, and buries them at the bottom of the sand or the bottom of the river we find buried. And the fourth stanza, the river is compared to a baby who gurgles or hums or is very happy sucking her thumb. So this is compared to a baby who makes noise of gurgling or humming sound. So very beautiful, the river is compared to a baby, one who is happy and sucking the thumb. The fifth stanza, river is compared to a singer. Now, while singing on the stage, a person makes a rhythmic movement and sings. Same way, the river also makes a rhythmic movement and sounds accompanied to it and flows down towards the plain area, that is countryside. So this is how the poet Valerie Bloom compares the river to a wanderer, winder, hoarder, baby, and a singer in this poem.